hear Christmas bells. It's Santa and his reindeer. Oh, so cute. Yeah, when you get close to December 25th is when Santa Claus comes by with his sparkly reindeer. Anyways, as fabulous as that is, we have our own reindeer here, and we are going to start playing around with some animal names and exhibit names for cheat-wise. Also want to mention, too, these cheats become completely negated when you exit out of the game. When you re-enter the game, if you want to have the animal houses or the fast scientists or all the dinosaurs available, you're going to have to rename people these things. So anyways, you reindeer. Okay, you're much slower. If we rename a reindeer Comet, all of our dinosaurs are supposed to disappear. Now granted, I only have a turtle up there. Don't point at the actual screen. There's a turtle there and my Plateosaurus, but I don't want them to disappear. But I'm guessing Comet, it's kind of funny because it's a reindeer name, and you know, it's like the asteroid that wiped out the dinosaurs. So one second, we'll just see here. Comet, there's your name. Do I have a turtle still? No, my turtle is gone, and my Plateosaurus are gone. Can we reverse that? No. Oh my gosh, we can't. We just got rid of my reptile house. I want that back. I think it makes total sense to me that there's a reptilian house in the snow area of the zoo. But oh crap, I'm going to have to adopt more dinosaurs. Oh, not that guy though. But here's an interesting thing too. As you can see, we're very, very low on money, and already just a giant tortoise cost me $500. Oh, zoo is low on money. Emergency fund. Yay! Actually, I have my own emergency fund, though. One of the cheats, and it's best to use this one at the beginning of the game because there's a serious side effect, is if we go shift and the number 4 button, that gives us a $10,000 bonus every time we hit that. But the downside is that one of our exhibits is going to have a destroyed fence. Yeah, Cerro Mountains has a broken fence. So, we'll just pause the game for a second. Also, the spacebar pauses the game, for any of you wondering. We'll just get a maintenance worker to fix the fence. Where'd the fence break? Right there. Oh my gosh. Right there is where it broke. So, actually, we could probably just pay for it ourselves, too, but there you go. We'll just fix that up. But yeah, so you can keep doing that for as much money as you need. There we go, another $10,000. But which exhibit suffered the consequences? Tiger Mountain. Probably not a good one to be broken. So, maintenance worker. Can you, fix the fence for me there? Fix it, sir? Thank you. Or ma'am. I guess you're a ma'am. Alright, so yeah, you can keep doing that for as much money as you need, and it's best to use it at the beginning of the game, because then you don't have any fences. You don't have to worry about being broken. So, hooray! But the next animal cheat name you can do is by naming a bear deer. Now, I'm not sure what kind of bear. I have polar bears here. They're the only bear in my zoo. There are also the grizzly bears, black bears, and Asiatic bears, as well as Magnet, a kind of polar bear. But we're going to name... I don't know if it's going to work because it's in its shelter. Okay, one second. We'll wait for it to come out of the shelter. Oh, there it is. All right, let's name you deer. How upset are you going to be that we gave you your praise name? Supposedly, it's just gonna like rage and don't go in the shelter. I want you to do something. It's supposed to just like break through fences, but it's just sitting down. Wow, you're a raging bear, all right. I think I've tried this one before, and it for sure worked with a Asiatic black bear, right there. So it's supposed to work, I guess. I don't know, I'm not really going to build a whole new exhibit for that. That's what it does, though. Or just makes, you know, a polar bear very, very content and passive. So the next thing, there's only two animal name changes we can do, but the next thing we're going to do is start naming some exhibits, and that's supposed to get some nice bonuses. Jamming jellies. We're going to rename jamming jellies to, well, it's kind of pointless calling it Copra Light Corner. What this does is if you have any dinosaur poop, it turns it all into rocks. But as you probably know, I have zero dinosaurs. So I don't think there's any poop to be turned into rocks. Let's see here. Nope, doesn't look like there's any in there. I don't think there's any in the tortoise exhibit. How sad. Oh well. Oh, jellyfish. Oh, it hatched! That was fast. The other one we can do is we'll name an exhibit Blue Fang after one of the developers of this game. Blue Fang exhibit will make the guests pay twice as much for certain attractions. So, whereas, let's see here. What's the highest? $6? They'll be paying $10 at this aquatic gift stand. So that's cool. More money. Yay. Extortioning guests. Isn't that what all businesses do? At Orca Ocean, we're going to rename to Microsoft, which will give us double the donations for anything, I suppose. Alright, another exhibit we're going to name is, let's name the Black Buck exhibit Wonderland. Naming an exhibit Wonderland is supposed to make it very, very popular. I'm not sure how you can really test that out. I guess even people who are coming to see it. Oh my gosh, all my hyenas, they're getting sick. Jonathan, fix them! Anyways, I think maybe if you... Wow, where are these guys going? Favorite animal, guest inventory. Yeah, it doesn't even really tell you where they're going. That person has some issues. They're super happy, but they're like thirsty, hungry, need to go to the bathroom, and are super, super tired. Makes sense, person. You're doing a wonderful job looking after yourself. So the next three exhibit names are going to unlock animals for us that we can adopt. Naming an exhibit. There we go. Super Croc will give us the ability to adopt the Super Crocodile or whatever its name is. Let's see here. There it is. Okay. Actually, this game actually gives you a pronunciation. Dinosuchus. Giant crocodile. We're gonna adopt one. That's all I can afford. We'll get rid of these trees too. Because it's not going to like those trees. What's it like? What's it even like? It likes a bald cypress tree. Well, when that thing hatches, we will give it an exhibit it will enjoy. I'm going to name another exhibit over here. We're going to name the giant tortoise exhibit. We are going to name it Cretaceous Corral. Corral, not coral. That will unlock the Triceratops for us. Where's Triceratops? There it is. Drop a Triceratops. Another savanna one. So that's kind of cool. As you can see, I don't have all the dinosaurs anymore because I restarted the game. So I'd have to name somebody Dino Man again. But whatever. So yeah, we could adopt a Triceratops if we wanted. The last name exhibit that we can name an exhibit. Oh, my black bucks are dying. So we're going to change our Wonderland, whatever, to Xanadu. When you name an exhibit Xanadu, it unlocks... Very strange creature. It unlocks, unicorns. There you go. Granted, this game has Bigfoot and has... there's a Bigfoot. There's the Yeti. Why not unicorns as well? So there's two other kind of like side... Fix that fence. Two other side unlockables that you can do to get another animal, another mythical animal, as well as another- Oh, it hatched! Oh, look at it. It is not well suited. It's not well suited. It's not happy with that exhibit. Not enough dirt, not enough brownstone, too much fresh water, not enough salt water. Okay, now that my Super Croc has a wonderful new exhibit that he is happy in. He has some food behind that tree. He's all honky-dory. We're going to do the last two things that I mentioned we were going to do before. So, I'm also going to sell us a hyena. Yes. I'm sorry, hyenas, but there's too many of you. Okay, so, well, let's make a small exhibit. Because we're not going to be using this exhibit. Alright. There we go. There we go. Exhibit 15 is fine. If you put a lion, a tiger, I find that the Bengal tiger works best, and a bear, such as a grizzly bear, together in an exhibit, what will happen is you will unlock a new type of pathway. The yellow brick road. Now let's just sell these poor buggers because they probably don't want to be living in a small enclosure together. But yes, you can
purchase the yellow brick path now. What does it say? Yellow brick paths indicate to guests where they should walk, especially scarecrows, lions, and tin men. Obviously, yellow brick path, Wizard of Oz. This is an expensive pathway. It's $100 per a section, whereas I think the most before is $50. So it's crazy expensive, but it's really, really pretty looking. Well, look at that pathway. Oh, it's beautiful. It's so beautiful. Yeah, it's fine. There's no animals in that exhibit. So that's that. So if you really want to spruce up your exhibits, or your zoo, I mean, right off the bat, and plus all those animals are available in the very beginning of the game. Yes, the grizzly bear. Well, we got the grizzly bear. Actually, yeah, I think the grizzly bear is available. The grizzly bear, the Bengal tiger, and the lion are all available at the very beginning of the game. You could probably put a Siberian tiger in there instead of a Bengal tiger, but I don't know. When I tried it the first time, I used a Bengal tiger, and it worked just fine like it did just now. So I don't see why fixing something that's not broken. I don't have any space near my marine. Oh my gosh, my foot is so asleep. In my marine area. To play as another tank. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna unlock the final animal that I'm at least aware of in the Zoo Tycoon, the first one. So we're gonna make a tank. Name it whatever. We'll make it a little bit taller. We're gonna place inside of it, let's see here, a mermaid statue. And lo and behold, why can't I put it in there? Oh, I have enough money! Crap, okay. Well, money cheat. Ooh. I have enough money now. We're gonna put a mermaid in there. And what's this? Shaky. We have ourselves a mermaid. Yes. So now you can have the Bigfoot, the Yeti, the unicorn, and a mermaid all in your zoo. All in your fictional section of your zoo. More foliage. I have no idea what kind of foliage you like. More animals the same type. She's definitely a social creature. One second, let's make her happy. It's not actually really all that important. I put some time, I remember, as a kid trying to put this guy in there too. But, no shaking. He remained the exact same. So sad. But it makes a really cool underwater thing. I wonder if we can put them in other exhibits. Can we put this pearl in there? Oh god, we could. That's really cool looking. Are you okay with the pearl in there, Orca? Yeah, it likes it. That's actually really cool. I would never realize you could put things inside water exhibits. Well, awesome. Well, lovely. Well, thank you guys for watching this video of cheats and unlockables in Zoo Tycoon. If there's anything that I had missed, go ahead and tell me. I probably won't make a follow-up video, but you can always tell me. I like learning. I like to learn these things. Make this mermaid happy as I'm talking here. That's always fine and dandy. And yeah, be on the lookout for a few other things. Of course, there's no cheats and unlockables in the first Zoo Tycoon, so you won't be seeing, or second one, I mean, pardon me. So you won't be sending any awesome videos about that one, but there'll be some cool videos coming up about that. So until then, I'll see you guys in the next one. Say goodbye, mermaid!